mystery in Indiana, what's causing songbirds to die suddenly all across the state? The DNR is investigating a deadly illness in 53 Indiana counties so far. CBS4's Mike Sullivan reports on what you should do if you find one of these birds.
Stacking cans and lining up spices.
Local farm goods.
You could call Odessa Wallace's food co-op her passion project.
The Indies Community Food Co-op is essentially a farmer's market that delivers to your door.
Her hobby, however, can be spotted just outside her shop.
And I'm looking at birds sometimes, yes.
From the nests along her building to the birds at her Far East Side home.
We go to places and watch birds, different ornithology classes and whatnot.
Only when she went to water her plants a few weeks ago.
There was this poor little bird that looked like it was sleeping, and it wasn't. I took a picture first because I had heard about all of the birds falling ill or dying.
When it comes to social media, cats, poisons, cicadas, not to burst the bubble here. But the DNR is still investigating the real reason behind the illness that is leaving birds with eye swelling and neurological issues.
Knew that I needed to file a report with DNR.
That can be done on the DNR website under songbird deaths.
When I filed it, I expected that somebody from DNR would come out and get the bird, test the bird.
In a statement, the DNR says they are not collecting samples at this time. However, if necessary, a DNR ornithologist will contact you to validate the death.
I didn't get a follow-up message. I didn't get an email.
In fact, her bird is still sitting where it was.
I knew not to touch it.
The DNR suggests people dispose of the birds in their trash using gloves and a sealable plastic bag.
I'm just watching, I think like everybody else is doing right now, to see what DNR actually comes up with.
In the East Side, I'm Mike Sullivan, CBS 4 News.
We have much more information on this songbird illness. Just click on this story at cbs4indy.com.